if we could, it would be lovely to start with characters and sort of
your character.
Who they are. I'm always a character. Who they are and where they're going in this first season.
I'm Jamie McShane. I play Dr. Tim Fanning. I am a scientist, becomes a neurologist. I went to Harvard with my buddy here.
Played Dr. Jonas Lear, who was a microbiologist, and we've known each other for a long time. We were best friends. We share a lot in common.
He has this expedition to find a cure for various diseases, and we find that there's a strain of a virus down in Bolivia, which seems to be prolonging people's lives and their, being able to fight diseases and all. So he enlists me to join him down there, and it goes very awry, and it really messes me up first.
He becomes the viral. He becomes patient zero. Taking back to Project Noah, we do tests on him, and the virus that he has is resistant to AIDS, cancer, Ebola, everything you can think of, and so we're trying to figure out how can we use that for a good, but we are heavily funded by a military department who want to use it for other reasons. That's our side of the story. We need, and we're getting hit at the same time by an avian type flu coming into America that's going to wipe out half the population in 12 hours if we don't get a cure. And then we decide, I think, to get this cure, we need to get, because we use our test subjects who are people, convicts from jail on death row, and then we decide to get a young girl.
Because the younger the convicts have been, the better it's worked on them, the less they've transformed into virals. So they decide to get a young girl.
So we need a young kid, and we choose Amy
Belafonte.
How does your character come to terms with that, with a child and doing experiments on prisoners and stuff? Is he okay with that all along, or is it a journey to get to
that's
there?
That's part of the character that I like doing. You know, here's a man who went out with all the best intentions in the world to find a cure for all these awful ills that the world has. Loses his best friend, loses his wife. Comes back and he just works and works and works. He's sort of in that unit the whole time, doesn't leave. He's just gonna see him in that unit, he's working the whole time. And then he gets to the point where I need to work on a child. So that is the moral dilemma. That's when it becomes interesting for an actor.
So how does the passage compare to The Hundred in terms of gore and scariness?
The Hundred is a lot more in your face and blood splashing on the screen. Not just saying that the passage won't, because we've only shot the pilot and I don't know what the other scripts are going to be like, but I think it's a lot more psychological, and there's a lot more heartwarming stories and a lot more about relationships rather than just that sort of fight. I'm not saying The Hundred is that, but obviously The Hundred has all that, but it's not going to be as hardcore, I don't think. I could be totally wrong.
From what you described, it doesn't sound like your character really gets into the heartwarming type storyline there.
I don't know yet, I don't know is the answer to that. I've only shot the pilot, but
I think he's in a lot of the heartbreaking, with things that happened. Like you said, he lost his best friend, his wife is dying, loses her, he's responsible, he's so pretty much responsible for all the things that happened in these three books, in this storyline, because of what he did. How do you feel about that?
Damn. Yeah.
That's so good.
Damn.
Have you guys read the books?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What did you think? What sort of drew you to this?
I think...
Well, we read them because we've got the parts.
Oh. Yeah, we read them because we got the parts. The way Justin writes and crafts the book, and he, in a way, you get a little lost, but you get to where you're like, all right, I'm going to trust this in getting lost. Because it happens several times for me during the course of the three books. And then it all ties together. Because you're like, wait a minute, who are these people? We just jumped in time. How did we get here? And then it all ties back so well. And I find it fascinating how when everything does go awry and the world, reverts back to a much earlier time, in that they don't have the cars, they don't have electricity as such, how people have to go back and start over again you know, if you look at the technology we have now with what you can do with a camera and, you know, Wi-Fi and internet and all that, and they have to go back to, you know, there's a junk of a car. How do we get it to run? How do we get it to move? What is it? You know, and having to hunt for your own food again or grow your own food. And, there, you know, I find it fascinating that sort of going back in time as such.
Do we delve much into your backstory and
yes.
get into the whole family relationship you had that led you to this and that kind of thing?
Absolutely. Yeah. You'll see me with like a dark beard, Jamie's hair cast out.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
The glares, all the heavy love power back in the 70s.
Yeah.
Doing the whole, we're going the way back to the early days of Harvard.
Yeah.
I don't know, but
we don't know.
We don't know, but we have a lot of backstory.
Thank you guys so much. Right.
Thank you. This doesn't mean you get killed off in the 100, though, right?
I didn't say
that. I do not get killed off.
He does definitely.
He does not get killed off.
Yeah, thank you.